Hi, this is Carly McAvoy. I'm trying to help you simplify or evaluate formulas in your assignment. And there's a lot of different notation in this assignment. And if you're not supposed to be familiar with all of it, if you don't know what these things stand for, then open up that document posted in your assignment called Formula for Stats. And that will help you with the different notation. This is asking you to find the standard deviation for a binomial distribution given that there were 15 trials and a probability of success of 56%. So that's two values. Looks like we need three. So in order to figure out what we're actually talking about, I'm going to go into that document and see what I have there. And I have this scrolled down to page 3 of this document, but notice there's a lot of pages. And if you weren't familiar with some of that notation, one of the things I give earlier is that this symbol right here is the Greek symbol for sigma, and that stands for population standard deviation. You can see it used in that formula, and we were using it down here on page 3 for this formula as well. And then N, P, and Q. N is the number of trials, P is the probability of success, and Q is the probability of failure, which is 1 minus P. So if the probability of success was 20%, the probability of failure would be 80%. So knowing that, I'm going to go back into this assignment, and now I know these things. I know that N is the number of trials, which we were given as 15. P is the probability of success, which we were given as 56%, which I changed to a decimal. And then Q is 1 minus P, which is 0.44. And so my problem here is going to be to simplify 15, the square root of 15 times 0.56 times 0.44. That needs to go into the calculator, and I just want to make sure that everybody can do that successfully. So we have, turn that on, I'm going to clear it, and then we have the second function square root symbol. Your calculator may be different, but you can go onto any YouTube channel, or not any YouTube channel, but you can go to YouTube and Google any calculator, and that will be fine. So we have 15 times 0.56 times 0.44, and then I'm going to hit enter. Now, this comes out to be a very long number. Notice that I was asked to round to the hundredths, and this is telling you to be careful with rounding. So I'm going to round to the hundredths. That is 1.92. And then once you get that answer, you may want to check it a second time just to make sure that you entered everything correctly. All right, the next one is just an easier formula, actually, minimum usual value. And they're asking you the question, find the minimum usual value given that the mean height for men in the U.S. is 69 inches and the standard deviation is 4 inches. And I can tell you that X bar, that's how we read that, stands for mean. And the lowercase s is the population or the standard deviation. Yeah. So I just have to plug into that formula to find the minimum usual value. If the mean height was 69, and then I have 2 times the standard deviation, which is 4. Then maybe you can do that even without a calculator. It looks like 69 minus 8, and that's going to be 61. And what does that mean? Well, what that means is that if you're a man who's 61 inches tall, you fall within the usual values. That's as short as you can be and still be in the usual values. Any shorter than that, then you become outside of the norm. And you could also add 8 to that and go up and say, oh, and that means that 77 inches or 6'5" would be the end of the norm on the other end of that. Okay, so that's just using that formula. And then this one is also not a difficult formula, but it has a little trick to it, so I wanted to show you that. Find the class width given that the maximum value for the data set is 104 and the minimum is 5, and you want 7 classes. So I'm going to do class width maximum of 104 and minimum of 5, and we want 7 classes. And so when I put that into the calculator, I can do it a number of different ways, but just, I don't care if I have a decimal, that's fine. So I have 104 minus 5 and then divided by 7, and that gives me 14.14. But notice I have this bracket around that. That means something. That means round it up to the nearest value that's as precise as your data was. So we had whole numbers, so we want to round this up to the next whole number, which would be 15. So I would not round down to 14, otherwise I would leave out some of my data values. So I have to always round up to the next highest number that has the same precision as what I was putting into that. So that would be 15. Okay, I'm going to pause this and do the second half of this on another video. So for now, I'll talk to you later.